Indeed, as you're all aware, and towards that end, I would want to take this opportunity to thank all those that we've been working in consultation with, especially the Kenya Bankers Association, who are represented today by their executive director, Mr. Habil Olaka, for supporting us as we have been trying to deal with the current issues that our economy is facing. In the same breath, I'd also like to ask other market players to work again in a similar manner to ensure that we do maintain a proper macroeconomic framework that ensures stability of key economic prices, including our exchange rate, our interest rates, and indeed the general price level in the country. And also to ensure that we do get a framework that will ensure we continue to support the kind of growth that we have been having in our economy, as well as continuing to ensure that we move and continue to improve the general welfare of the people of Kenya.
Now, the KBA has looked at these measures that measures that can be availed to the existing borrowers to help them ride over this period of tight monetary policy aimed at fighting inflation, which has mainly been driven by the spiraling food and energy costs. The KBA, having consulted with the Central Bank of Kenya and the government of Kenya, have taken some measures, the five measures that the minister alluded to, which are as follows. The first measure was to extend the loan repayment period for the borrowers. This will ensure that the borrowers can still be able to meet their borrowing obligations at the levels at which they were meeting before the recent interest rate increases. Secondly, the banks have agreed to capping the maximum interest, the loan repayment amount, to a maximum of 20% in consultation with the borrowers. This means that the installment will then be spread out, leading to an extension of the repayment period. This is essentially a combination of spreading the repayment amounts and an extension of the repayment period to fit into the required installment repayment by the borrower. Thirdly, the absorption of the costs by the banks. Since the interest rate adjustments may precipitate loan defaults, banks will absorb some of the additional costs from changes in the macroeconomic environment to the maximum extent possible without threatening their viability. This really entails sacrificing a portion of their budgeted profit margin. These measures and the one immediately below are hinged on the premise that while short-term interest rates will increase, lending rates are also driven by other factors. These factors include opportunities for investment, and overpricing loans may kill avenues for investment. These factors will prevail and will be more important once the inflation war has been won. The fourth measure is that banks will not raise their interest rates despite the recent further increase in the central bank rate by the 1.5%. You'll recall that on Thursday, 1st December 2001, the Monetary Policy Committee met and adjusted the central bank rate upwards by 150 basis points to 18%. Banks will absorb this increase and mitigate the additional burden on existing borrowers. But this will only apply to the existing borrowers. The interest rates for new loans will, however, not be accommodated within this measure. And finally, the fifth measure that the banks have taken is to remove any penalty on early repayment of loans, where the banks have decided, in case the borrowers decide to prepay or repay the loan before the contractual due date, the banks will not levy any penalty, despite the contractual terms in the agreement. And all these measures have been taken by the association in view of the fact that we are sensitive to the plight of Kenyans and are supportive of the government policy for the national goals. And for this reason, the KBA has gone to great lengths to ensure that the banks absorb the effect of the adjusted the adjustments in the costs in the short run. This will enable the borrowers to be able to overcome this short-run period when we have got the interest rates increase in the market.
I think only just to reiterate again that what we are dealing with are indeed short-term shocks that have been caused in many instances by some of the factors that he has indicated. Price increases internationally that are beyond our control, food prices as a result of the drought that we've been experiencing. But I think that some of the measures that we have already been taken have begun to bear fruit. We have seen exchange rates now beginning to stabilize. I do believe that, with the drop in food prices, the stabilization of the exchange rate, we shall see some of our external prices also dropping. Again, really just to ensure that we bring to check this remaining monster of inflation so that it doesn't continue to affect our growth path and again also the lives of many Kenyans. And towards that end, I think some of the other actions that we have taken, we're happy to note that the IMF has also approved the review that they were undertaking, which I think will also result in additional flows into the country to help us continue stabilizing the shilling as we move forward. And I think I'd like to invite at this stage the governor of the Central Bank just to give us a few highlights.
This is a press release on the IMF Executive Board as it completed the second review under the extended credit facility for Kenya and approves the request for augmentation of access of $143.67 million disbursement. The statement, I'll just deal with the first paragraph so that even if you get it, you see the highlights are just summarizing the whole idea. The Executive Board of the International Monetary Fund today, that was on Friday, completed the second review of Kenya's economic performance under the three-year arrangement under the extended credit facility. The board, that's what we call the ECF, the board also approved an augmentation of access equal to 60% of the quota, of Kenya's quota, which would lead to a total access of 180% of the quota, an amount equivalent to SDR 488.52 million, which is about $760.63 million under the ECF arrangement. The board's decision enables the immediate disbursement of an amount equivalent to SDR 92.276 million, which is about US$143.67 million. This brings to a total disbursement under the ECF arrangement to an amount equivalent to SDR 200.836 million, which is equivalent to about $312.7 million. That is the first paragraph of the highlights. And these highlights are important for us. I think you recall when we started this, it was actually for balance of payment support to reduce the pressure on our current account, merchandise account, but at the same time support the international liquidity in the bank. This is a way of building reserves for ourselves. And it is going to support us in the efforts or the policy efforts we have to stabilize the exchange rate. For us, we are very, very appreciative of this. And even the commentary from the IMF and the totality of the board was to support the policy direction that we have taken. We believe we'll win the war. We'll win the war against inflation because it's coming from out there. But these measures are very, very supportive. So I thank you very much for this.
Thank you. Most of the information is in the various press releases that you will get. I think what is important to recognize is that we can see a collaboration in place between various market players aimed at dealing with the current shocks that the economy is facing and understanding that these are short-term shocks and equally, more importantly, an understanding that various institutions want to work again with their various borrowers to ensure that the Kenyan citizen or the shock to the Kenyan citizen is as minimal as possible. Because ultimately, we do believe this is a short-term problem that we are addressing. and that will be brought back to line. And that is why I'm saying we are appreciative of some of the measures that are being taken by the banks to ensure that ordinary Kenyans are shielded from the shocks of this short-term problem as we continue to deal with it. So I think that really is the critical point. And if we were all to be able to work in collaboration together, I believe that we can overcome this particular situation and restore normalcy both in the financial markets and in the overall economy. And that is why we will continue as a government to encourage market players to be able to work together as partners so that we can overcome this and get back again on our growth trajectory, again aimed at improving the lives of ordinary Kenyans. So I think in conclusion, mine is once again to thank the Kenya Bankers Association and their members, to thank the Central Bank, and also on behalf of the Treasury and all represented here, to take this opportunity to wish Kenyans a very Merry Christmas and indeed a prosperous 2012 as we move forward. So I think with that, thank you all very much for your kind attention. Asante ni sana.
Thank you, and thank you, members. Thank you very much. Asante sana. Asante.